بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون.
قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said in a hadith that whosoever stands in Ramadan, meaning for Salat al-Tarawih, all his previous sins are forgiven. محمد رسول الله عليه
وآله صلى الله. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل الله فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. فقد قال الله تعالى في شأن حبيبه مخبرا وآمرا قولا كريما: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم وسلم عليه. صدق الله صدق الله المولانا العظيم وبلغنا رسوله الحبيب الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
I greet you with a greeting which has such great effect on the scale of deeds. Once a companion entered the gathering of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, "Assalamu alaykum," and the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, "Ashara." And next, after a while, another companion enters the holy gathering of Sayyidina Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he says, "Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh." And the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replies, he says, "Ishrun, 20. And then the next companion enters and he says, "Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh." The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Thalathun." Then 30. So the Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in inquired, "O Messenger of Allah, what do you mean?" So the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said that when a person greets his fellow brother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward him 30 rewards. That Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi says in one of the beautiful traditions of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that when a person does a good deed in the month of Ramadan, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless him 10 times more. So I honorable, respected, revered ulama-e kiram, dear elders, brothers, friends, mothers, sisters, and the viewers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, By the grace of the Almighty Allah, we witness and welcome this beautiful month of Ramadan. Indeed, this is a great favor upon us. As the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had mentioned in one of his traditions, whereby he had said that indeed the month of Ramadan is the chief of all months. So welcome this month. Alhamdulillah, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us this opportunity to witness the first Jummah of this month. How sad is it? There were some people who desired and had hope in reaching to this month of Ramadan, but unfortunately, their hopes deserted them and they fell into the darkness of the grave. How sad that a person who reached the month of Ramadan, thinking that he will reach the night, unfortunately, before the night could come, he passed on. How sad that a person who desired to see tomorrow, before the next day could appear, he left this dunya. This is the life of this dunya. As Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi beautifully say, مَدَى الدَّهْرُ وَالْأَيَّامُ وَدَمُّ حَاسِلٌ مَدَى الدَّهْرُ وَالْأَيَّامُ وَدَمُّ حَاسِلٌ وَجَاءَ رَسُولُ الْمَوْتِ وَقَلْبُ غَافِلٌ نَعِيمُكَ فِي الدُّنْيَا غُرُورٌ وَحَسْرَةٌ وَعِيشُكَ فِي الدُّنْيَا مُحَالٌ وَبَاطِلٌ. Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi mentions that time and days passed away while we are still with sins. The angel of death had come to you while your heart is still careless. Your worldly blessings are only a deception and desires. In this world, everlasting life is difficult to find. Indeed, we are in this month of Ramadan. But how sad that when the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had prophesied, there'll come a time when this ummah, when jihalat will increase, ignorance will increase in this ummah. He was talking about the time where you and I are in. Today we do not understand the excellence of this month. How sad that to some of us, this month is a month which is full of burden. To some of us, we find it so heavy upon our shoulders to stand in Salatul Taraweeh. That once, it is mentioned that once one of the sons of Harun al-Rashid foolishly said, Da'ani shahru sawmi la kana min shahrin. Da'ani shahru sawmi la kana min shahrin. وَلَا سُمْتُ شَهْرًا بَعْدَهُ آخِرُ دَهْرِي فَلَوْ كَانَ يُعْدِينِ الْأَنَامُ بِقُدْرَةٍ عَلَى شَهْرِي لَأَسْتَعْدَيْتُ جُهْدِي عَلَى شَهْرِي. One of the sons foolishly said that the month of fasting call upon me. May that month be destroyed so that I don't have to fast ever again. This was the saying of one of the sons of Harun al-Rashid. He says, may this month be destroyed so I don't have to fast again. For if people could help me to fight against this month of Ramadan, I will fight this month with full effort and courage. When he finished making the statement, it is mentioned, the ulama have recorded, that when the son of Harun al-Rashid made such a statement, what happened to him was that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put upon him a sickness. And the sickness was fits. That it is mentioned that every day without fail, since he said that words, he should get fit. That before the next Ramadan could come, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took his soul away. So this is the importance of this month. Unfortunately, today, we do not understand the value of this month. Today we have religious freedom in our country. I was watching Al Jazeera on Wednesday. China had banned Muslims in the northwest province from fasting. Something strange that today the Muslims of China in a certain province is stopped from fasting. Today we have freedom to express our deen, but unfortunately, we do not value this month of Ramadan. Today, we do not understand the excellence of the month of Ramadan. Indeed, the great Salafus Salihin, the pious predecessors, they understood the greatness of this month, that they sacrificed their time, the day, and the nights in the ibadat of Allah. These were the great personalities of that time. Today, we'll only prepare for Ramadan on the night when we hear the siren or when we see the moon. But the predecessors, the pious predecessors, when Ramadan approached, they did not prepare only on the night of the first night of Ramadan. But they prepared well before, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa balighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, bless us in the month of Rajab and Sha'ban and make us reach the month of Ramadan. This was indeed the words of Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These only are Allah of that time. They shouldn't read it only when Sha'ban came. Hazrat Fadl Rahmatullah Ali, he should read this dua, and he says many of the awliya of the time should prepare and read this dua 6 months before Ramadan. Every day without fail they should ask Allah, oh Allah, let us reach the month of Ramadan. And when they should reach the month of Ramadan, then the awliya Allah of that time, what they should do, they should all say, oh Allah, please accept our fast for the next 6 months. They should make the same dua, oh Allah, please accept our efforts in the month of Ramadan. They understood the greatness of this month. Unfortunately, you and I, we think the month of Ramadan is like any other month. That it is mentioned that Hazrat Yahya ibn Abi Kathir rahmahullah should supplicate for 6 months, oh Allah, keep me safe and secure for Ramadan, and make Ramadan safe and secure for me, and receive my fast in acceptance. For 6 months he should cry in the court of Allah. He understood the value of this month. Today you and I do not understand the value of this month. That the Sahaba Ridwanullahi Ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, they should sacrifice their time for the pleasure of Allah. Today the Imam has to go 1 minute later in Taraweeh Salah, then we are ready to complain. But remember Sahaba Ridwanullahi Ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, when it came to Ramadan, they sacrificed every moment because they understood its value. Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا جَاءَ رَمَضَانُ فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ وَأُغْلِقَتْ أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ وَصُفِّيَتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. How lucky are we in such a month that in this month all the doors of Jannah are open. How lucky is it for a sinner that in this very same month all the doors of hell are closed. How lucky is it for the Ummah of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that the shayateen are locked up in this month. Once, there was a person, he purchased a slave. So when he purchased the slave, he brought the slave home. And the person was Hazrat Ibn Salih. Actually, he sold the slave to someone. So when he sold the slave to someone, so the slave started to the slave. The slave went to this house where she was sold. So when the slave went, she saw the people busy preparing food for Ramadan. So she inquired, "What is this preparation?" So the people say, "We are preparing for the month of Ramadan which is about to arrive." So the slave said, "By Allah, I was staying with such people who every day was Ramadan. Every night was in ibadat, every day was in sawm. Oh my master, please tell me back to my previous owner. Because I want to be in that company, in that gathering where every day is fasting and every night is qiyamul layl." There was another slave, another female slave. A person says that I purchased the slave. So the slave came to our house and she said, "Oh people of the house, it's time for salah, it's time for salah." So the people got up and they inquired, "Is it time for Salatul Fajr? Is it time for Salatul Fajr?" So the slave was astonished. She asked, "Do you only wake up for Faraid? Where I was staying before, my previous owners, when they should wake up, they should wake up for Salatul Layl. I wish that I can go back. Please send me back to my old owners." This was the life of the Salafus Salihin, the pious predecessors. But unfortunately, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said, "Man qama fi Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." Whoever stands at night in nafil salah out of devotion and sincerity, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive his previous sins. Today when the imam is leading us in taraweeh salah, we complain. We always want to look at the time. Oh, today it is 5 minutes later, the other masjid finished 5 minutes earlier, so I'll go there. This is our situation, my dear brothers. But the Salafus Salihin, time never worried them. They always engage themselves in the ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That when they should come into the musalla, that one Sayyidina Ali karramallahu wajhul kareem, he was passing by the masjid and he saw the masjid was written up, people standing in rows for Salatul Taraweeh. So when Sayyidina Ali karramallahu wajhul kareem saw this, he was so happy to see the people standing in Salatul Taraweeh in Jamaat. Yet he exclaimed and he said, "Oh Allah, illuminate the tomb of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, for indeed he has lightened up the masajid of the world." When he made this dua, comes to mind the hadith of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whereby the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said, that if one person lightens up the house of Allah, as long as that light is shining in the masjid, then 70,000 malaika are asking forgiveness in the court of Allah for that person. So, oh Allah, please forgive Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. These were the pious predecessors. Today, when the imam takes 5 minutes, we complain. Now since it is the World Cup, the quarter final, if it has to go to extra time, no one is there to complain. If it has to go to penalty shootout, no one is there to complain. But when it comes to the remembrance of Allah, then everyone is there to complain. My dear brothers, today we have lost our focus and our direction. And our direction is supposed to be for the pleasure of Allah. But unfortunately today you and I, we are running after dunya. Indeed, this dunya is going to leave us. Indeed, this dunya is going to leave us. How many desired to get this month of Ramadan. But unfortunately, before they could come to the month of Ramadan, their place was indeed the grave. When the people of that time, they understood the greatness of this month, that when they should go into sajda, when they should keep fast in this month, as Imam Shaykh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, very beautifully, he says the month of Ramadan, the word Ramadan has 5 letters. Ra, Mim, Dad, Alif and Noon. He says that when a person goes into the devotion and to the remembrance of Allah, then he gets Ridwanullah. He gets the pleasure of Allah. That when a person gets the pleasure of Allah, then the meme of Ramadan stands for Muhabbatullah. He gets the love of Allah. And when that happens, then the dawn of Ramadan first stands for Dimanullah. And that is the guarantee of Allah, meaning he will be guaranteed spiritual upliftment. That when you take the alif from the month of Ramadan, that is indeed ulfatullah, the intimate affection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When that is present in him, then indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant him another thing, and that is nurullah. Then the light of Allah will be shining on his face. I ask the Almighty, since I see my time is up, I ask the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the ability to fulfill the rights of this month, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our efforts in this month. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.